Tuned to Headbangers Ball Operation Rock and Roll Special from Dallas, and now I'm joined backstage by the first of two British bands on the bill tonight, Motorhead. So, Lenny, Wizzo, Wurzel, hi, I'm Filthy, how are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
How are you?
Great, I'm fine.
Good.
Now, after...
God, you're lovely.
After a very successful European tour, you were forced to cancel some club dates stateside. What happened there?
What club dates? Oh yeah, well we were doing this tour instead, see. Mm-hmm.
Wasn't down to illness or exhaustion as we heard?
Well, I wasn't. He's usually ill down there. He's ill now, look at him.
So, how's it working out for you on Operation Rock and Roll?
You're doing
about it. So far so good, you know.
Well,
that's
what
you can hope for, boys and girls, believe me. And don't talk at the same time. Remember what they told you?
Well, an interview going on here.
You were ill, not me.
I told you. Listen.
Tell him, Phil.
It was him that was ill, not bleeding me.
Let's have a punch-up.
Listen, everybody was ill, right? And then everybody went on tour as well.
Right.
Just because
okay.
I'm made of wood.
What do you think of the other bands on the bill?
Difficult to say, really. We haven't seen two of them. Because we keep having to leave after the show, you know, so we don't see the two top bands much. Well, I've seen them, it's a good show, you know. Mm-hmm. I think it's a good five bands, really. Mm-hmm.
And we've heard that Motorhead...
Been the best, like, you know.
Well, that's what we heard. We heard you've been getting the best press out of everybody.
We've been getting some great press, haven't we?
Yeah.
I got a trouser press the other day.
Love me forever. Oh, not at all. End of our tether. Backs to the wall. Give me a hand. Don't you ever ask why. Promise me nothing. Live till we die.
Sweet for you that this album has been so well accepted stateside.
Yes, about time too, if I might say so.
Now, being used to headlining status yourselves and having such a wealth of back catalogue material, how do you adapt your set to just 30 minutes or so?
There's a difficulty.
Yes, with difficulty. Tonight we're doing 40 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Thought we'd put in another couple of songs. I mean, it's just the way it goes. Unfortunately, us doing 30 minutes, we like to do an hour.
Gotta get it while you can, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, we've never headlined in America except when we've done club dates, so if we go out on a big tour, we used to support, and we've supported a few people already.
We make sure the 30 minutes is good anyway. Mm. It's the best.
Right.
Best 30 minutes you've ever heard, folks.
Amazing.
How do you think that 1916 has broadened your audience out?
Well, they've got fatter, they're eating more hamburgers.
Yeah, four or five of them are 6 foot across now.
Yeah.
But we don't hold up against them, you know, we're broad-minded.
Now, come on. Answer the question,
come on. Well, no, it seems to be, it's obviously the best-selling album we've had in America, so it's all on the up and up, you know. Mm-hmm. I'm happy with it.
Okay, well, that sounds like a good opportunity to go into a video.
That's a beautiful tool. I never noticed that before.
So, yes, even more, I think we should get into a video now. This is I'm So Bad, Baby.
I don't care.
Operation Rock and Roll Special from Dallas. We may be indoors, but we are in Dallas. Now, more questions. I read in an interview at the time of the LP release that you said that Motorhead had been on a treadmill for many years. Do you think that with 1916 you're off that treadmill?
Yes.
Hope so.
Do you remember saying that?
It's on the back of the album, actually.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Yeah, I mean, obviously we are, yeah. We're getting more publicity, more coverage. You know, coverage. And
it's the best album anyway we've done, so we're off the treadmill, yeah. I think it's the best album the band's ever done. So.
Yeah, it certainly is. Better than Ace of Spades, everybody, although that's the one we keep getting stuck with. Neat.
Now, I have a question for you, Lemmy, and
oh, no.
I hope you
really?
Don't mind me bringing this up.
Yeah.
But when I saw you on tour in Europe, I was very honoured to be shown a couple of songs that you'd written, rather like 1916, i.e. you'd written them from another person's point of view. Do you think that those particular songs will appear on a future Motorhead release, or are you going to continue developing that idea?
Well, they'll appear on something, I'm not sure yet. Maybe I'll sell them to somebody, you know, make more money. I don't really know, you know, maybe they'll come out, maybe they won't. Silver Star and Daddy Kiss Me Goodnight, yeah.
Now, I was lucky enough to see the lyrics to those songs, and they were very thought-provoking, and I felt
sorry,
very honoured.
Sorry, cute, I wouldn't show them to ugly people, you know.
Would you be prepared to tell the viewers what the themes of those two songs were about?
No, let them be surprised. I like surprises, don't you? I love surprises. Sheila hates them, look.
It's always a surprise with Motorhead.
Yes, we're full of surprises.
Can I just ask you, Lemmy, again, is there anything you'd like to do creatively that you can't do within the framework of Motorhead?
Yeah, everything else, you know. I mean, but you can't do everything else. It's we do whatever we can get away with, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know that. Do you get the chance to write new material on the road together?
We do, but we never write any until it's time to write something. You know, I got to talk into the camera, right? Until it's time to write it, we don't write a thing.
Okay, and just really
postcards.
Oh, postcards.
And I'd just really like to know your plans for the immediate future. What have you got coming up?
More, another album, more tours, things like that. More interviews on MTV.
Good.
That's it.
With you, Vanessa.
New T-shirt.
Largest bogey in Motorhead contest.
And you've got a live video out as well, haven't you?
Yeah, it's called Everything Louder Than Everything Else, which seems a perfect title to me. What do you think?
Yeah, it's good. Yeah, it's very funny. It's very funny. He's just been released in Europe, I'm told. And yeah, I've seen it once or twice. It's good. Yeah, you should get it.
It's excellent. Actually, go out and buy 5 copies. We deserve the money.
Yes, all 5 of you. Immediately. All 5 people are watching this.
I think the 12.
Know all your names and your addresses. And the shop where you bought the equipment.
We know where you live.
After you mentioned the bogey competition, it's up to 15 now, Phil. It's only
every second, yeah. Oh dear. Well, on that note, I think it's time for us to see some more music. We're going to see your second video of 1916.
Are we?
Yes, which was?
I don't know. What was Japan, baby Adam Kerr?
We've seen that.
That was the second.
I don't know.
The second. Oh, our version of
No Voices in the Sky.
Oh, is that one?
Yeah, that's the one.
Moorhead is a scuzzy piece of that's noisy.
But we don't think about the dress much. I wear a dress sometimes. Lemmy's got a good dress. Maybe summer frock.
We always just thought of ourselves as Motorhead music.
Danger. Has to be dangerous, man. Also, it ain't rock and roll.